Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you 10 things you may not know that you can do with images in the Preview app. MacMost is supported by viewers just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content. So we've all used the Preview app to look at images and PDFs. And there's a lot of things you can do with both. You may know some of the things you can do with images, like say add annotations. But there are a lot of other features of Preview that you may not know about. So first, let me show you that you can use Preview to import photos directly from your camera. You connect your camera to your Mac or the SD card to an SD card reader to your Mac. And then you can run Preview and go to File and then Import. And in this case, I have an SD card for my camera connected. And I'm going to get a list of photos and videos on my card. And I can see information about them. I can select one and I can import it. I can Command Select to select multiple or Shift Select to select a range. And I can import them all. I could also select an individual one and remove it. I can go with this list view here or a grid view here at the bottom as well. You can also use Preview to scan directly from a scanner that's connected to your Mac. You don't have to use the software that came with your scanner. So you can go in Preview to File and then you should see your scanner if it's connected here. Then you could bring it up and you can get a preview. And then you can select all sorts of options here on the right. You can select an area to scan and then you could scan and it will go directly into a new document in Preview. And from there you could save it. Now when you open up an image in Preview, one of the many things you can do with the image is you could adjust the colors. So with the image open, just go to Tools, then Adjust Color, and it brings up these controls here that are similar to what you find in a lot of graphics apps. So you don't necessarily have to open the image in a graphics app to do some simple adjustments. You can adjust the exposure, you can adjust contrast, highlights, shadows, the color saturation, all sorts of things. There's an auto setting here. You can also play with the levels yourself manually at the top. And then when you're done, save and your changes will be saved directly to the image. You can also export an image in Preview to another format or to a different compression level. So let's go to File and then Export. And then here you can see I can export and I can choose a format. And there are a bunch of different formats. The new HEIC format, JPEG, PNG, TIFF. And some of these have controls like JPEG, for instance, has a quality control. Lower quality means a smaller file size. You can see 1.3 megs, but of course less quality. Higher quality is going to mean a much larger file, but the image will look better. Now one thing that's missing there is the ability to export at a different size. But you can change the size of the photo before you export. So go to Tools and Adjust Size. It brings up this whole control here where you can change the width and height in pixels. You've got pixels, percent, inches, and other measurements as well. So you can go to percent. Let's go to 50% here. You can unlock the width and height. So you can basically stretch it out horizontally or vertically. You can also crop an image. To do that, simply just select an area of the image and you can adjust using these blue dots here. And you can get to exactly where you want and then go to Tools and Crop or Command K and it will crop to that. Then you can export and only get this portion of the image. Now Preview has the ability to actually get information about the image that you're seeing. If you go to Tools, Show Inspector or Command I, you have several different tabs here of information. So click on I here at the top. You've got general information. You've got information from your camera. You've got picture metadata. All sorts of different things that you could look at. You could also click here to look at file information as well. Now if you want to be precise about your colors, you need to get a preview of what this image will look like if you display it on a certain screen or print it on certain paper using a certain printer. There's a tool for that in here. You go to View and then Soft Proof with Profile and all these different profiles will appear. You'll probably see different ones depending on what you have installed or connected to your Mac. So you can choose a different profile here and it will slightly change the colors that you see on the screen. If you use it, make sure you turn it off when you're done. Go back and select None. Now Preview can do slideshows. The way to get a slideshow going is to open many images in Preview. So I'm going to select all here and do Command O to open them. And it'll open them all up in Preview. So now that I've got a bunch here, I could see them in the left. If you don't see them, you can turn on the thumbnails here. Then you can go to View and Slideshow. and it will show it as a full screen slideshow, and it's automatically playing. So you'll see it fade from one image to the next. You can also click the pause button here at the bottom and X to exit. You can use the arrow keys to flip through the images very quickly. You can also cut out part of an image and use it in another image. There are several different ways to do this. Click on here to turn on the annotations tool, and then you can select a way to select something. So you can do a rectangular or say elliptical selection. So I could take a selection like this, and then I could do Command C to copy, go to another image, and click on the image to select it, but then Command V to paste, and you see I get this floating object here. If you want to be more precise, you can select either the lasso selection tool or the smart lasso tool to outline an image. So you can see here I've outlined myself. The smart lasso tool will cling to the edges. I can Command C to copy, go to another image here and click on it, and then Command V to paste. And now I can paste this selection into this new image on top of it. If you want to highlight something in an image, you have two options. You can go to Tools and then Annotate, and you have Mask and Loop. You can also access those if you turn on the Annotation tools, and then you go to the Shapes and they're at the bottom. So Mask puts a rectangle here and you can adjust the edges and corners of it, and then you can position it to highlight what you want and the rest of the image is darker. You can do the Loop and it adds a circle here, and you've got these two dots. The blue dot will enlarge the size of the circle. The green dot will increase the magnification inside the circle. And you can also add more than one of these loops if you want. If you have a bunch of images open to preview at the same time and they're in the left sidebar here, you can go to a different view called Contact Sheet. And this will show you small square thumbnails of each image. You can double click on one to then go into it. Then you can jump back to the Contact Sheet to see them all. Note there's a keyboard shortcut for that, Option Command 6. So I can go into here and then Option Command 6 to go back to the contact sheet. So in addition to these items, there's of course the full set of annotation tools that you could use to mark up your images in Preview. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.